this man and he'll try it.
Universal spinning globe, and actually right in front of the Universal Studios Hollywood, the entrance, which is back there. Yep. So anyways, I'm here right now and reflecting on this very special day to reminisce what I have done and why I got here in the first place. So I would like to reflect on this particular event that happened on this special day, if you look at it. I'm talking about One Kapamilya Go. Yep, it happened on that exact day. It's already been, believe it or not, 8 years? 8 years? Man, my goodness. 8 years already since I last been here. And believe it or not, this was the last time I've been at Universal Studios. I don't believe it, man. Time flies, man. It flies by so fast that when I look back on that day, I'm thinking, dang, that is such a long ass freaking time since I last been. I don't believe it. Well, yeah, anyways, it did happen on this day. And I do remember how hard it was for me to get over here, considering the fact that I had to take 3 different transportation vehicles. Mind you, I did not have a car that time. I did have a license, but I did not have a car. I remember having to ride the 460 bus to get over here, and then taking the red line at the metro station to get me to Universal City, that then led me to riding the shuttle to get me all the way up here. Yeah. What's up, man? Mind you, I was a college student back then. You know, I was already in my last year, and somehow I managed to get myself all the way down here just for that event. And for 2 particular people I wanted to see. And yes, the Mara Clara girls, Julia Montes and Kathryn Bernardo. Yep, I remember seeing them over here. There's no question about it. They were the reason why I came here. And so on that day, you know, I saw them at the Global Amphitheater. It was a crazy ass line over there. All these people were just rowdy. You got a rowdy crowd out there. I don't believe it, man. I do remember sitting somewhere in the back area because I came in a little late. The show started around 2 o'clock, but had I driven over there, I probably would have gotten the front seat. It's a first come first serve event. Yeah, I remember sitting around the back somewhere, kind of like on the right side, I think. And I did meet this girl. Yeah, she's Filipino too. She had a piercing on the left side of her chin, I think. But I remember her name was Jean, and she would be a good friend. She would be somebody I could befriend. She's pretty chill. She's pretty nice. But too bad that I lost her after the show. So after that, I just went on my own to ride studio tour, and then after that, I rode Jurassic Park the ride. And nobody was there on that line. I think the park was about to close for that time. The event happened on a Sunday, so therefore I did go on a Sunday, and you know. Yeah, but that was a crazy day overall. But for the most part, it was fun. It was fun even seeing them in person for the first time, which made this day so damn memorable. It's one of the happiest days I ever had to be here in Universal. So yeah, I mean, really enjoyed it. And so yeah, I do remember being here on this particular day. September 18, 2011. I will show it again if I have to. Yep. This is still my proof, and I'm still wearing it today to reflect on this special day. No, not 9/11. 9/18. No, not 9/11.
9/18.
This day is my happiest day I've ever had to live for of this entire month. and I have to say, man, it's so unforgettable. You know, even if it was so tough to get down here, you know, even if I had my nearby close moment of missing the bus, the 460 bus on my way back home, the 460 bus on my way back home. You know, I was just a lucky ass motherfucker, you know what I'm saying? But it was such an unforgettable day. I remember seeing them. I really couldn't see them up close until I saw them again at the LA Convention Center for that Film Expo. My gosh, they were so beautiful in person. You know, considering they were the first ones I saw before I even saw Erich Gunkaiko. The funny thing is, I did start to get into Julianne Kathryn at the beginning of that year because of Mara Clara, one. And then all of a sudden, it just happened so fast that I saw them in person. it was just a crazy year, man. And I saw them right there, boy. Again, dude, heard them singing Mara Clara on the stage in person. My gosh, that experience is so unfreaking forgettable, unfreaking believable. Oh boy, and I can't believe it, man. I tried to get somebody to go with, but I just ended up going by myself. You know, back then I felt kind of disappointed because I didn't have anybody to go with. My mentality was so different back then because every time I go out, I always rather have somebody to go with, like go to a certain place, even if it's just like watching a movie or going out to eat. But nowadays, look at that. Look how many places I've been to by myself now. Look how many places. Hikes, watching movies, going out to eat, doing a number of things by myself. By myself. And do I give a shit? Fuck no. Looking back on this day, man, I'm glad I did it and I show no regrets.
By myself.
So, looking at today, so I did it and I did it for the record.
By myself.
I came close to the point where I thought I wasn't gonna go. I came down to that last minute, dude. I got the ticket.
By myself.
I think it was like before I saw their movie way back home in the theaters. I remember buying that ticket at the Seafood City in Norwalk.
By myself.
And mind you, I did not know the Cerritos area very well at that time. I didn't work at that time. I was still a student in Cal State Fullerton. but yeah, point is, I bought a ticket. It was only $60 at that time. And I have to say, now it's not really that expensive if you think about it. $60, man, it is so affordable compared to the general admission price now, Universal. I wonder how much it is right now. Last thing I heard was it was like about 110, 109. Now I'm hearing it's like 133. Now I don't know if I'm hearing that correctly, dude, but you know, for the sake of it, with all these changes that's happened and the fact that the Jurassic Park, the ride has renovated into a Jurassic World, fuck it, man. It's like the price has skyrocketed, no doubt about it. I think it's 133 to get to Universal Studios Hollywood. My gosh, everything's getting expensive now, dude. It's no fucking joke. As I continue to reflect on this day, man, it's very memorable. It's still unforgettable, even like maybe about 10, 20 years from now, you know, as I continue to look back on this day, even now, I still love Julianne Kathryn. But with so many things going on, dude, I just can't drool on them anymore as I used to. Like then, especially on that, I used to write about both of them. More so of Julia because she was my beloved idol of all. You know, I loved her more than Kathryn. I mean, I love Kathryn too, but I've always loved Julia, and no matter what, even up to this day, I still have, you know, always written about her, how crazy it was about her, but you know, I deserved the moment to be here, and I'm very thankful that it happened. So I gotta say, man, will there be a future time that I will see them again? Will there be another opportunity like this? Maybe, who knows? I'm not really gonna rush on it, you know. But 2011, September 18, man, it's still gonna be a day to reflect back on. I know it's already been about 4 or 5 straight years that I've reflected on this day. It could probably be the last time I'm doing it. So I'll probably meet them one more time, who knows? But we'll just have to see about that. It's always nice to do a throwback like this, you know, once in a while. I still love them both. And, you know, shout outs to Julia, Montes, Kathryn Bernardo. I don't know what's going on with them these days, you know, but maybe in the future I'll probably see you two. Maybe a Growing Up 2 series, I don't know. Mara Clara 2, who knows? You guys are maybe really busy with other projects as well, but in the future, you know, I hope to see you in person again. Maybe I'll watch you on the screen again, but who knows? But this tells it all. So yeah, this is the one day I'm never gonna forget about. This is the proof, and I'm still gonna keep it. It's part of my memorabilia, and so this will be kept for life. I am not gonna lose this forever and ever and ever. Look at that. Yeah. All right, I'm heading out now. I got work tomorrow. Just came all the way here to reflect on what's happening, but anyways, I gotta eat now. I'm getting hungry. So, cut the fucking tape. It's pretty cold out here. So, cut it.